We are back here to review the weekend episodes of Bigg Boss Marathi. There could be a lot happening, that's what I thought, because throughout the week the tasks that were done, there were some interesting things that could have been spoken about by the host, but unfortunately once again there was a letdown. The Saturday's episode was ridiculous. There were some stupid games being played where each contestant was supposed to be given the tag of some animal. There were cue cards placed, there were placards with the names of animals, and the host Mahesh Manjrekar was asking an opinion poll from the rest of the contestants, like, whom do you think best fit that particular title of that animal? And more or less, you know, everyone had unanimous opinions about who should be what, but the reasons that were given, it was kind of disappointing. I just thought that the contestants have reached a stage where they are being overcautious. Rather than being themselves, now they are being completely guarded. And none of them were very honest in giving the reasons for that. Everyone was trying to be just goody-goody, giving all the, you know, positive reasons, making it sound as if, you know, this is the best title that can be conferred on a particular contestant. So the reasons that were given were all very goody-goody, and obviously because of that it sounded very fake. Bhushan was the only one who at least tried to be a little more honest than the others, but still, you know, it was still all positive, but at least the reasons that he were giving were quite nice. And so the Saturday episode was all about games, that's it. So Sunday episode, we were just waiting with bated breath. When will Mahesh Manjrekar finally come to review the tasks that were being played? And we were also waiting when he would talk about Megha, Resham, Rutuja, Pushkar, Sai. Some mention about a rift between Megha with her friends, Sai, Pushkar, anything. But none of that happened. He did gloss over what happened. He did put each of the nominated contestants in the courtroom to defend themselves. Nothing much interesting, because basically the episode was devoted to Mother's Day special. So we had mothers calling up their children to wish them and motivate them. We had children calling up mothers to motivate and inspire them, and, you know, keep telling like how good they are doing a fantastic job and all that. The call from Megha's daughter was very cute. She did say, just enjoy the game, don't be so obsessed with everything, you're making us proud, and just be yourself, just enjoy. The best thing that happened was Au's son, when he called up. Now Au has been constantly telling that you know, her son had made her promise that she should not pick fights with anyone in the house, and she should not use any abusive language, and she should remain calm, composed, which is why she is holding herself back. So now we had our son who's coming and telling, you're doing a good job. So if you are bound by the promise that I made you take, okay, I'm taking back the promise. Now you're free. So we would love to see what Au does now that she's not bound by the promise that she's made to her son, because apparently her family was not very keen in her participating in the show, which is why they made her promise. Probably they know what Au is capable of. So now we would like to see Au getting back into her form. That will be some interesting watch. Eviction, I guess it was a foregone conclusion that it would be Anil Thate who would be evicted. Somehow his energy seemed to have dimmed over the past couple of weeks, and he's not his earlier self when he was this entertaining and controversial Anil Thate. So he had kind of mellowed down a lot. There were hardly any frictions between him and Au, and they had more or less, you know, arrived at a truce where they had decided to be pally with each other. But it was very nice when he got evicted, the entire house was in tears. I would say this has been the best eviction so far. No one was, kind of pleased or happy about it, and everyone was genuinely moved by his eviction. You know, that's what one should aim for in this show. Give yourself 100%, do whatever it takes for you to assert yourself. But then you should be winning hearts of not just the audience but also of your fellow contestants, and that is what Anil Thate did. This was the right time for him to go out. He earned the respect of everyone, and you know, the big transformation I would say was in yesterday's episode when he was evicted. He was not the Anil Thate that we had seen entering the house. He was a sober Anil Thate that Big Boss house had transformed into. He was no longer dressed in all that jazzy outfits with all his jewelry and everything. He had worn something very sober. He had worn denim and a shirt which was given to him by another fellow contestant. None of those flashy jewelries and no ticklies and bindis all over him. So it was a very nice, mellow down Anil Thate, and I hope he continues to be so once he steps out of the house. In the promo for the next day, we see Rajesh entering the house, and I don't know the timing. You know, Resham is seen sitting with Juhi Gadkari and talking, you know, mentioning that she misses Rajesh and, you know, we've not heard anything from him. And then the door opens and Rajesh walks in. This is too melodramatic, too much for coincidence. So somewhere that's one gets a feeling like, you know, how this timing all is planned. It can't be too much of a coincidence. You can't have Rajesh waiting outside the door, waiting for that moment when somebody would mention his name and then the door opens. That would be too far-fetched to believe. What we expect is a little more credibility from Big Boss Marathi, and I think the team should take notice of the views expressed by its audience. Rajesh coming back into the house, personally I was always against that. He doesn't deserve to be in the house. But, and you know, the best part, if one sees all the wood shots after Rajesh left, you know, over a period of time the team had all bonded. They were seen, you know, sitting at the table and eating at the same time, all of them, and having some really cool conversations without hitting at each other, pulling each other's leg, Megha often being targeted and all that. But it was all in good humor, good jest. It made for a wonderful atmosphere in the house. But with Rajesh coming back, will the dynamics change? Will it ever again revert to this old divide, you know, Rajesh gang versus the rest? And will all his you know, the coteries or his followers again flock back to him? Will Resham again become the negative vamp that she was earlier? Because she was really coming out as a very interesting and positive person. I really wish that wouldn't happen, and I really hope that Resham continues to remain positive and be connected with the rest of the contestants. And I really hope that Arshad and the others, you know, maintain a neutral stand and not become blind followers. Let's hope. It will be interesting to watch what happens tomorrow. And before I sign off, just a reminder, please like, share and subscribe for more updates on Big Boss.